So we are heading down south on I-5 to Lake City Way. But it's slowly because a lot of places they order they don't have yet.
Okay.
A lot of country they just have slowly. Even South Korea, they only do about 5% of the people. You know, because take a while. Because U.S. we take all the vaccine, and then England and Europe they all ahead of time. You know, who has the money? They buy everything already. So the leftover is whatever country they order they go last. That's why it take a long time. Maybe by the summer, by October or September, most of the place they start vaccine already. So because now we have so many here and nobody wants it, you know.
That's the interesting dynamic is a lot of people don't want the vaccine.
Yeah. They even give money out. You see, in New York, they give you like $1 million. That's your one thing.
Yeah.
They give you a prize if you go like a lottery thing. Do the vaccine, you put in your number, and then we call every week, we give a lottery thing, prize, raffle, whatever, and you win $1 million.
I know.
Just because you get a vaccine, what?
Yeah.
Overseas, people dying just to get a vaccine, and here you have vaccine, nobody wants it, that's why.
India.
Yeah.
You see that? That's horribly sad.
Over there, they have like 300,000 every day infected.
Every day, yeah.
Every day.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I'm surprised.
We have people in this country that don't want it.
I-5
makes
south.
No sense.
Me, that's why I come back. The day right after, I have no appointment, so there's one open in Tacoma. I drive like an hour, just go down to get the vaccine.
Yeah.
Because that's all booked up here.
Yep.
So I go straight down there, and then a month later, I see something open here, so I go here. So. And then I read the news now that they even have the vaccine tourists now. A lot of people from Mexico, they buy the 2 packets up here. They get a shot free in New York or Florida. They give out free shots now. And then they wait out or they come back and then they come back again the next month to get a shot. So they are all good. Because if you wait in the country, probably a year later, they haven't shot yet. That's why. So This is I-5. We go all the way to south to Seattle downtown and straight down to Portland, Oregon, and then to California. So, and then go north, we go to Canada. So,
yeah, they still have the borders closed too.
Yeah, because over there they have no vaccine. And even Canada, imagine they order the vaccine but nothing available. They even asked for free from US. That's why whoever has the most money control the vaccine, you know?
Yeah. Wait, what do you have for lunch, babe?
I made myself a sandwich.
A sandwich?
Yeah. It wasn't like yours, but...
No,
it was
good.
Something. I had a couple pieces of multigrain bread, deli meat, piece of light cheese, a little bit of mustard, and that was a...
Really?
I had that at
1
o'clock, yeah.
You should stop by Albertson. They have like they always have food, you know, free. They have a deli there.
Yeah.
They got everything, fried chicken, yeah. They got ribs, they got like orange chicken.
No, believe me, when I eat, I just didn't want to eat a bunch of food right in the middle of the day. Plus, I was in my backyard cleaning up and doing things, so I just threw something together real quick.
Oh yeah, I went there today 2 times already.
Uh-huh,
really
yeah.
Nice.
It's nice, big, huh?
Yeah, really big. It's like 30 acres over there. Have you been there?
I've seen pictures.
You should go there sometimes.
Yeah.
Wow, she got like, she, they have chicken, they got ducks, everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, 30 acres.
Wow.
So you go there and even have another river, Snohomish River.
Yeah.
So you even if you have a boat, you can put a boat down there right on the river.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that one, I asked my sister husband, can you build any house? No, this is a farmland only.
Yeah.
Basically, you cannot build anything except a house. So
what they plan then? Last time, Big Becky said she planned to build a wedding building.
Yeah.
That's her dream, babe.
Yeah, maybe that.
Really?
Yeah, she want to build a big platform wedding,
okay.
People reserve wedding to build.
Just like some place, like a golf place or something, like a big place, but you cannot build like a condo like this.
Oh, yeah.
It's a farmland.
Right. Probably single dwelling, you know?
Yeah, single dwelling.
Yeah.
You do some one purpose thing, or either you do farming or you do something like sell this, sell that, but you cannot build a community apartment like that, no. But that always changed. I remember years ago we ride up here, it's all like farmland. And all of a sudden people build houses everywhere, you know? And then, yeah, things always change when the population go up.
Yeah, I've been in that area almost 30 years, and 30 years ago it was crazy.
Yeah, farmland, right?
Yeah, just dirt roads,
the road
would end, like nothing.
Yeah.
And now all of a sudden there's developments, new schools, high school. Everything now,
yeah, because population they increase like almost like double every few years, right?
Yeah.
So we just left Everett. Now we are in Linwood, and then now this is Lake Forest Park. Now we just left Mount Lake Terrace, and then this is a shoreline. Now
my mom lives over there.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
By Lake Forest Park,
Shoreline.
Oh, Shoreline,
that's where I was born and raised.
Oh, really?
Uh-huh.
Because when I was here, I went to Shoreline Community College there,
yeah, okay,
yeah. So a long time ago, that's like 20 years, 15 years, whatever, 20 years now, 15 years, whatever, 20 years.
Wow.
That's a long time.
You These silly Asians don't age though. I didn't want to ask you your age. I guarantee you.
I'm 48. I'm younger than she's
yeah, but you look like a little kid, to be honest.
Yeah, he's so young.
No, I mean honestly, I'm not. You just Asians just don't.
No,
age.
Because I'm always active.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
I'm never sit in one place.
Yeah.
Every day I walk for like 10K easy, you know, yeah. 20K whatever.
Oh yeah, he told me to.
Yeah. So, but the guy's smart. I mean, you can tell he's extremely intelligent.
Proceed about one. But the thing is, if you go to invest someplace, unless you spend like half your time there, you know what it is, then you do it. But don't be like somebody said, oh, let me buy a property like in Miami, Florida, or buy a property in all the way Massachusetts, or go to Mexico. But you haven't been there.
Yeah.
Whatever, sign people, it's all fake. The next thing you know is your money is gone because of it's all fake paper, right?
Yeah.
Unless you're going to live there and stay there most of the time. Then it's okay. But the thing is, for me, if I see something like that, I rather invest in America because here we got all the rules, everything, right?
Yeah.
All I do, or just go in there, go back to the stock market, buy like Apple store or something company like Tesla, guaranteed 10-20% investment there.
Or Amazon.
Yeah,
Google,
Amazon, Google. Yeah.
Microsoft,
you put money there, 10-year guaranteed 10-20% easy.
Yep, exactly.
Over there, like you never know, your money be gone next year, 5 years all gone, everything bankrupt, or people run away, people gonna pay you, you know. I don't like that. I like guarantee, at least, you know.
Yeah.
I don't like something that all like imagination, you know.
Yeah, well, like right now. Like right now, Bitcoin and all that cryptocurrency.
Yeah, be careful.
That is so volatile. Yeah, yeah. No. I've heard some nightmares.
I heard a lot of people lost money and they go bankrupt, so don't even touch that thing, you know. Nothing is all imagination, right? If you are a risky person, but you know, unless you are a real trader, like you are a Wall Street trader, you know,
exactly.
You go to make money.
Yeah.
But like me and you, you know nothing about that, and then, you don't want to put all your money and go on. The next thing you're on the street, living on the streets. I don't like that stuff.
Yeah, in fact, I had a guy at the gym about a year and a half ago. He was starting some sort of cryptocurrency business, and the minimum investment was $10,000.
No.
And I thought about it.
Don't do that,
but man. I didn't do it.
If you're gonna do it, go to Robinhood. All the apps. That's my sister told me.
Yeah.
Download the Robinhood app. You can buy your own.
Yeah.
It's no fee, nothing.
Yeah.
You can put there. You don't like, you go sell. Like put $100, $200, $300. Don't trust anybody. Because I saw so many. I saw some people. Every day I read the news on there. Like somebody run away with your money.
Yeah.
Somebody online because you know there's so many fake schemes, whatever Ponzi schemes,
man. Yeah,
I read about that. That's why I don't trust. Unless you're gonna do it, go straight to what is that, Swaps? Bank of America. They have the investment there and there. Go. Don't talk to them on the street. You're gonna do it. Go straight to the big companies like. Yeah. I think Bank of America, they have, what is that company, the investment company, I forgot.
Charles Schwab?
Yeah, no, Charles Schwab is different, and they have like, or you can do online, if you don't like, just open the online account.
Yeah.
And then just buy and just leave it there, buy a little bit, you know.
Yeah.
But don't trust anybody.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're gonna make money, go up there, buy some stock of the Apple, you're gonna make money, I know. Or back, like you said, Amazon, or buy Tesla or something like that, you know, or buy Google, or you know, some big company like Moderna, like now, go buy the Moderna. They're gonna make money because people need vaccine right now, right?
Yeah.
You buy it and put there. I guarantee you, in a year, you probably make 10-20% easy, right?
Yeah.
But go to something that because that one before, you know what, Bitcoin go up. Everybody buy it, and now a lot of company because they burn so many power, so much energy. So China they ban it because most of the people that do the mining thing for Bitcoin is in China. So they shut down all the mining company for Bitcoin. So they shut down. So now they go all the way down because that one is just unless it's approved by the government around the world, then it's good. But right now it's just like in the air somewhere, you know. Oh, you want investment? Buy a piece of land somewhere.
Yeah.
Guarantee you, in 5 years, you want to be a ruined up more. Because, you know, property don't always go up, right?
Yeah, well, it's a matter of finding it. Finding something that, one that's affordable that you want to own, you know?
Yeah.
Because, like, housing here is just crazy.
Yeah.
I bought that house in February and bought it from a friend of mine. And I'm glad I did it when I did it because it's just crazy. They say the average house in the Seattle metro area is selling for a minimum of $50,000 over asking.
Keep right.
Oh, yeah.
Left turn.
You know, my sister, Nancy, she see the real estate also. You know Nancy?
Yes.
Northeast she the mortgage broker or whatever. Every time you sell a house, like, people give up with a price. For example, you want to sell $1 million or $500,000, they will give, I give you $600,000, you know what I'm saying? Because now house is so under, really not enough. So we go to Lake City. Down here is Lake City, Washington.
Yeah, I remember
proceed
this
about 4/10 of a mile to the end of the road.
Hunt, remember this road?
Yes.